Okay, so let's start. Welcome to a new Aten presentation. More like welcome to a new Aten demo, because today we are only going to have demos. And I have thought to combine all of the previous YouTube channel videos and our midday Thursday presentations, all our other Thursdays where we present just very specific topic, like last week we had power efficiency and 2 weeks prior we had KVM over IP. So I was thinking, how about to combine this in just one image, in one presentation, and do some combined hands-on, and how to work when you're at home, or how to work with your home equipment, and how to work with your remote equipment. So for that to be easy to understand, I have created a map of the equipment that I have on the table right now, and I'm going to very shortly introduce you to the equipment that we have. So I will do the introduction of the equipment, then we are going to focus on this map, and then I'm going to show you how to work and how to interact with them. For that, let me open my recording, because this is going to go on YouTube. So we are recording, and let's start with the top right, top left corner. Okay, so first of all, we have our camera, and it's a regular HDMI camera. We're going to record with this one, we're going to post on YouTube, and it's going to help me zoom in to certain equipment that are very interesting. This camera is connected via an HDMI cable, this one, to a UC3020. Okay, I'm going to show you in a moment. And this one is connected to my USB-C. Now, why did I do that? Now, right now you're looking at me via the webcam. And I would like to, when I want to show you the surroundings, I want to give you an overview. And moving the laptop is like really weird, and I don't really want to do that. So for that, I'm going to change the camera from the webcam, which is here, to the HDMI camera. So now, hello, I can give you a better perspective on how our setup is looking like. So bear with me a moment to dismount the camera and show you the equipment that we are going to work today. Okay, so I have taken the camera out. So this is the UC3020. It's connected to my camera, the camera that I'm shooting right now. And this one is connected to the USB-C, okay? And now it allows me to actually show you better views. This is the home table. So everything what's in this table up to this margin, okay? This is home and this is work. So these are the equipments that usually we're going to use in our office, in our server room, in our control room, etc. And these are the equipment that we are going to use in our home. And in the back, I also have a tablet. Okay, so we're going to play with the tablet also. So starting with, should we start with the work or home? Let's start in the home. So in the home, I have the VP2120. This allows collaborative environment with my colleagues, and I'm going to show you how. These equipments allow HDMI, my HDMI input, my HDMI output, which is this one. I want to push this image to different equipment. So push it out of the laptop. And because the destination is really far away, I'm going to use an over IP extender, which is already working, okay? And I'm going to show you where I'm going to push the image of my desktop. So also we have a tablet here, and this tablet is connected to a docking station here because I want to play very nicely with my tablet. Okay, I want to play very nicely, I want a nice experience, I want to put the image on this nice monitor. Okay, I want to put this image here. I want to attach a mouse and the keyboard, so basically I want to play better. Also at home, because I'm filming, I have a de-embedder, okay? And this de-embedder is actually connected to the camera I'm filming right now. The de-embedder allows me to detach the audio from the video and also acts as an extender. Why do I want to detach the audio? Well, for instance, if I would put this in, if I would like to take the audio of the HDMI cable, if I would like to take the audio and put it in a very nice speaker system, not the speakers of the monitor, which are really bad, I can tell you that right now, but in a very nice amplifier audio system, I need to detach the audio and give it a go there. And also for streaming, again, for YouTube, for allowing this camera to be connected directly to the laptop as an input, so I need an HDMI input to the laptop, then I use the UC3020. And moving a little bit to the office side, I'm going to show you the aggregator, the multi-view switch. This allows me to take up to four inputs. Yes, so it will allow me to take one, two, which is that PC over there. This is the second input. Third input, that would be my PC here. This is my third input. And my fourth input, which is here in the corner, my fourth input is actually, if I lower down a little bit, you will see that there is a CD player over there. So this is my fourth input. So what this product does, it actually combines all the four images in one single monitor, okay? I have this black Asus monitor here. All the four images are going to be combined. And also, because I have a mouse attached and the keyboard attached to this product, I can control what's going on all of the servers. So now I'm controlling the server, now I'm controlling the laptop equipment. Okay, I can click it, I can put a password, and now I'm controlling what's going on my computer. Okay, so I can click on my computer, etc. And moving on, I also have here a KVM over IP. I'm going to show you, I'm going to hands on it, but just to see where it is positioned. And in this KVM, I have connected the server, and the server, it's over there. It's under the CD player. So that one is the server. When I'm saying the server, that is the Dell station that acts as a server. Okay, so I'm going to connect it here. And also, I'm going to connect this docking station connected to this tablet, also to the KVM over IP, because why not? Also, I have an Apple Air. And the problem with Apple Air, I'm going to get a little bit closer, is that it has no ports. So basically, it's just the power, which is here, is the USB, which is here, and on the other side is just one single Thunderport port. That's it. I don't have HDMI, I don't have network besides the wireless, which it came with. I don't have anything. So I would like to multiply the ports of this laptop. I would like to add HDMI, I would like to add more USBs. So I'm actually using a docking station just for MacBook Air. It's this one over here where I connected the HDMI, the USB, and I have connected also the Thunderbolt port. Okay, so the Thunderbolt, it's here, it's over here. That allows me to take the image of this laptop, and put it somewhere else, for instance, in my aggregator, in my multi-view. So that is a very short recap of what equipment I have. So now let's work with this equipment. Let's see what we can do when we have this equipment. Let me put the camera back. Okay, so let me put the camera back, and now let's start with the office. Why not? Let's start with the office. So, how to work with equipment in the office? Now, right now I am home. Again, this table here, in this direction, this is home. And this table over here, this is considered to be work. So, I am at home, and I'm looking at the picture one more time. Okay, So I'm here, I'm at home here, and I would like to work with the equipment that are over the internet in my office site. So let's start with, what should we start with? Let's start with the KVM over IP. Okay, we will start with the KVM over IP, which is here. So basically what I want to do now, I want to delete those. I don't care about those. I have my laptop. I would like to go over the internet here, and then over the internet I would like to go in my KVM over IP, and I would like to control the server which is on my office. Okay, so how to do this? Well, first of all, if you're choosing a KVM that also have LAN ports, it means you can go over IP on this KVM. So by having these LAN ports, it means I can allocate an IP. If I have an IP, which I do, of course, then I can connect to my KVM over IP. Let's do this now. Okay, so let's connect to the KVM over IP. And we're going to not go to the interface of the product. I can do this and then download the Java client. So I have my IP, very simple, press connect, administrator, I don't remember if this is, maybe it's like this. Okay, so server is ready, which means I'm at home, I'm connected to my work KVM. Switch to remote view. And here, as I told you, I have two things connected. So on my KVM, so to my KVM, I have two things connected. Via a processor or an adapter, call it as you want, I have connected my station, and via a secondary one, which is on the second port, I have connected my docking station, which in turn connects the iPad. So let's see what I can do if I have the access to the KVM over IP. Let's go to the server first. So double click. So I'm on the server. Okay, I am on the server. Right now I can work just like I'm working with any remote software. Okay, I can browse this, I can execute things on it, I can check status, monitor, everything that you do with regular over IP access to one of your servers. And of course the question is, why do I bother with such an equipment? I mean, surely we have TeamViewer, we have VNC, remote desktop connection, and so many other programs that you can work with. So why do I bother with this one? Well, you bother with this one if you want something more, like access to the BIOS of this station. How about installing a new operating system on this one? How would TeamViewer or VNC help you install a new operating system or completely remove the operating system of this station and just freshly install a new one? So it cannot. That's why you need a KVM over IP. While it's booting, I can show you also something very interesting that you can do with the KVM over IP. And that means, that is, I can attach more media drives to my station. For instance, where I'm going to install my operating system from, okay? Because I'm not physically there. There's nothing there, it's just the station. So I need a USB or an ISO file put on an USB to install it. So how do I mount, how do I get this USB up to there? Surely you don't thinking to send it via a courier or something, that's not how it goes. So if you press here on the USB sign, which says virtual media, then you add, and then you choose what you want to add from your own computer to be mounted on the server. So for instance, let's mount a drive. Let's mount a drive. Okay, and maybe I want to mount my Pro AV. Okay, add. And mount. So now I'm mounting something that exists on my computer. It can be either a USB connected, an ISO file, etc. And this is going to be available, here it is, on the server. So now I can start again installing something new, like a new operating system, etc. Or I can enter the BIOS, I need to restart the station one more time, and I can start the process there. It's entirely up to you. But I can copy something, for instance, I can copy this presentation here, or I can just start it. So again, this is my computer, but it is mounted as a drive on the server computer. So these are things that you can only do with the KVM over IP, installing a new operating system, run the BIOS of that station, etc., etc. I'm still remote, so how about we move to the tablet? So from port number one, I can go to port number two. This is my tablet, which is right now in standby mode. I'm going to grab it, and I'm going to open it. Okay, so this is the tablet. And this is the camera of the tablet. Of course, I can switch it to regular view. So this is how the tablet looks like. These are the menus. I can start with it, etc. And I can also film if I want. If I want to stream with my tablet and you do not know how to do it, well, now you know. Okay. So this is the tablet. So I can see various things with my KVM over IP. It is true, these are mostly server-oriented things that we are presenting. But however, if you're crazy enough and you want to connect your tablet, you can do that as well. Okay, so let's close the KVM over IP for the moment. Okay, so I have shown you how we enter remotely the KVM over IP. I can show you that I can see stations remotely, and I can interfere with absolutely anything that's on the station. Absolutely anything that's on the station. So right now, let's undelete everything that we have deleted from the previous one. Okay, so let's undelete everything. So now that I have shown you this, there is a question. What if this server remains completely blocked? Let's say I get an error and the operating system is not responding and I cannot do anything with that. The command has come from the keyboard, that blocked, everything is blocked. Can I remotely reboot this station? Can I remotely cut the power for this station? And the answer is actually yes, because we also have in our infrastructure, we also have an equipment that provides monitoring and control over the sockets. Let's see how this product works. And first of all, let's see this product. Like, let's see how the product looks like. Let me grab the camera one more time. Let me detach it. And the product that I'm talking is over here. It's actually, I need to move the laptop. It's this one. Okay, so this product, which have IP connectivity, also have 8 sockets. Okay, it has 8 sockets. I also have a sensor, which is right here. Okay, this is the sensor and it's connected here. This is a temperature and humidity sensor. I can control the sockets. I can control if I want to give power to my server or not, and how I want to give or remove power from my server. Okay, let's put the Apple back. Let's return and see how this remote power works. Okay, how can I control the power? Okay, so I have mounted the camera back to the socket, and now let's return to our presentation. In order to go, I also need an IP for this one. So I just need to control the power for the station, the laptop, it's a docking station, and also this monitor. I have put also this monitor to be controlled. So let's go to the IP of that equipment. 10.0.42.130. Okay, so this is my PDU, intelligent PDU. Okay, this is the menu, and this is on default. I am inside the menu of the PDU. And again, because this is an over IP product, I can access from anywhere, any place. I can access from my home, from a different country. I know that we cannot travel nowadays, but Anyway, when we could travel, then we will be accessing from another country, etc. You can see I have a reading on temperature and humidity because, again, I have a sensor attached to my device. But the most important thing that we enter here is that I want to control my station. Okay, I want to shut down the power and turn on the power from the station. And in order for me to show you better, I will reopen the interface of the KVM over IP showing the server, not the tablet, but the server, okay, which is this one. In order for me to turn it off and on, I can just press these buttons, okay? I can turn it off right now, and after it's off, I can turn it on. But the interesting thing is, how am I going to turn it off? And I have a couple of options. The most simple one is to say, kill the power. Okay, this is the most simple thing. And my intelligent PDU will immediately cut the power from the station. The problem is that maybe on the station I have some work in progress, maybe I'm copying something, or maybe there is some work that needs attention before the station actually loses power. So I don't really want to cut power like immediately. I want to inform the station that I'm going to cut the power and let the station close its work and, you know, safely shut down. In order for me to do this, the station needs to have something that we call wake on LAN and also shut down on LAN. So that means I'm going to send a command to my station, which has a particular MAC address or a particular indicator, if you would like. So I'm going to send a command to say, hey, dear station, I'm going to close the power on you. I'm going to give you a few moments for you to safely shut down. Let's see how this works. I told you that we have an equipment we call the multiview, which takes many up to 4 directly and up to 16 if you can, if you have up to 5 of these. So if you have up to 5 of these, you can have up to 16 inputs on the HDMI, which you can connect to a single monitor, and also you can control from a single monitor. And for that, let me go back to the camera on the video presenter. Let me make this a little bit bigger, because now I'm going to show you with the HDMI camera. Right now I have 4 screens. This is my laptop, this is the server, this is the iPad Air, and this is the DVD player that we have below. So what do I mean actually control? Okay, I have a mouse attached to this product in the back, it's over there in the back, and I have a keyboard attached. Again, I have the keyboard attached and I have the mouse attached, it's here. So now, because I have these beautiful 4 screens, okay, I can actually, if you can see my mouse, now I am doing stuff on my server, okay? I'm opening folders, I'm starting something that's over the server. Well, actually, that's remotely coming from my PC, but doesn't matter. So it's on the server, so I can do stuff on the server. Okay, so you can see my mouse is over here. Now, if I'm going down, this is actually where I enter my laptop. Okay, this is the screen of my laptop. So now, whatever I'm doing here, I'm actually doing on my laptop. And I don't want that because I'm filming with this one, so maybe I don't want to interfere with that one. However, we can go to the MacBook Air. Okay, so let's do something on the MacBook Air. Let's put a password. Okay. So now I'm doing stuff on MacBook Air, okay? Now I'm doing stuff on MacBook Air. I can open, let's say, the Safari browser. That one is not connected to the internet, but anyway, if it would be, it will open. I can see the pictures, I can listen to the music I have, etc. I can, I don't know, buy stuff or just play with the settings of this device, etc. So as you can see, with just one mouse and one keyboard, I can control up to four devices, just moving this mouse left and right, up and down, okay? And again, I can, if I have, for instance, in this location, if I have another aggregator, if I have another multi-view here, that one can be split into four as well. So if I go over the whole image, I can have four, 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 and another four. So I can have up to 16 computers that I control with only one mouse and one keyboard. Okay? It's very useful, especially in control rooms. Very, very useful. Let's return to our presentation to enter a little bit in our home entertaining. Okay, we are in the home table. And I have already showed you the docking station of the tablet. We have an iPad Pro connected. I would like to have a better multimedia experience and a better gaming experience. Okay, so for that, let me return to the camera. So for that, again, I have the tablet, which is here, and this is connected to the docking station. What I do not have right now is a mouse, but I'm going to take the mouse, and I'm going to take the mouse from here, and I'm going to attach it to the docking station. So let's do this now. I'm taking the mouse from the multi-view, and I'm attaching to the docking station. I want to take my iPad, and I want to put it on my monitor, because I want a nicer multimedia experience. Now, in order for me to do this, I need an HDMI cable, because this is DisplayPort. I need an HDMI cable to connect it to this monitor. So give me 1 second to do this. What I want to do here, okay, just a second. As you can see, I have opened the tablet, but also I have the image on the very nice monitor that I just attached. Okay, let's also unlock the tablet. Okay, so now, let's play. I can see some pictures, for instance, high quality, of course. And let's go here. Okay, so these are some pictures that we did, and we can browse between the pictures. Okay. Many thanks to George for doing a very nice presentation. And I can also play. Okay, I can play. And you can see, you can probably hear it. Okay. Oh, and also, if you remember, I have attached the mouse. Okay, so... Now I'm playing with the mouse on the monitor. Okay, if you can see the dot moving to the screen. All right. So I can enhance a lot my multimedia experience. I can enhance a lot my multimedia experience. And it doesn't matter what you have. If you have Android, or if you have an iPad like I have right now, if you have a USB-C connector like this one, you're good to go. Okay, you just connect this to your docking station, and then you can expand. You can add a lot of things, like again, mouse and keyboard, display port, HDMI port, or you can connect to a KVM over IP, which is over there. You can de-embed the sound. You can take the video from this one, and you can record it to your laptop. If you're a gaming reviewer, you might want to do that. And you, of course, you'll be using what I'm using right now, the 3020. This is how I stream to you right now. Okay, so let me put the camera back, and let me present you the presentation switch. Okay, so this is the initial image of the presentation switch. It asked me to introduce a name as a participant. Let's say Sorin. and it will ask me for a room. Okay, now the administrator will tell me the room. If it doesn't know about the room, then I can just enter the interface of the product, and this is the room number. Okay, so it's not even that complicated. So let's connect as a participant. Let's say I'm Sorin. So now I am connected to the presentation switch. Okay, and together with me, I have the server, also it's connected to the presentation switch, and I have also my my colleague Marian, which is connected to the presentation switch. If I want to collaborate with my colleagues, which are already in the room, I can go to control panel, and I can see that one of the people in the panel is actually streaming something. So that would be Marian, and Marian is actually streaming something. And let me show you better. So I'm going to go live with the presentation. Yeah. This is what my colleague Marian decided to stream. What about if I have multiple people streaming? Okay. Do you remember I also have a server and I can connect to this server? So let's do this now. So let's connect to the server, connect port 1, I don't want this, and I don't want this. So let's connect also with the server, and let's say that the server is sharing, what is the server? Let's say it's sharing these materials. Okay, so now both Marian and the lab server is sharing something. As you can see in the background, I have a split screen. Okay, I can see what the server is sharing and I can see what Marian is sharing. And also, as a participant, I can decide to start sharing something. For instance, I would like to share my drawing because I'm considering that this is important for the presentation. So as you can see, we are three people sharing at the same time. Okay, as a participant to this collaboration environment, I can decide to which one I want to focus. So I can focus to all of them, of course. I can just zoom in and I can wait for all of them to show me what they want to show me, etc. I can present something on the schematics, or I can focus on someone. Let's say I consider that what Marian is sharing is very important, so I click on Marian and then I zoom in and I'm focusing entirely what Marian is sharing, okay, without impacting the others. Maybe Marian is not interested in what Marian is sharing. Maybe he's interested in what the server is doing. Maybe he's interested in what I'm doing. So this presentation switch, to which all we gather and see, we can share together things, or we can work independently, and then I can see the result of my colleagues, and it's a collaborative environment. For instance, right now you're looking at me via Teams, and Teams is a great platform. Don't get me wrong, Teams is a great platform, but you can only, or it is better for you only to see my shared image. I cannot see your shared image. So if you want to share something, I need to refocus my attention, and not in a very nice way. So I would say this is something like Teams or Zoom, but much better if you want to collaborate. Okay, so this is the presentation switch. Very easy to use as a user. Now, again, I'm a user. I don't know IT, I don't know anything. I'm just receiving a link from my administrator, and my administrator will say something, hey, connect to this link and use this room code. And that's it. It's not complicated to use. And also this collaborative environment have other different things like a whiteboard, so you know I can draw, and my colleagues or the server, I can enter the server and I can draw something back if I consider to be helpful. So let me do this now. So if you go on the whiteboard, I'm going as a server, I can see that, you know, sorry, draw something there. So maybe I want to draw something back. Maybe I can say that after coronavirus, you know, sales are going to go up and business is going to be back on track, etc. So we can do collaborative things between us. Okay, so now I can see it as a user. With my laptop here, I'm connected to the interface of the PDU here over the internet. Okay, I'm over the internet, so I'm connected over the internet. I'm connected here, and I will try to cut power to one of my servers in the office. Okay, I will try to cut power. So let's see how this goes. I will just cut the power. I decided I'm no more Mr. Nice Guy. I'm just going to cut the power instantaneously. So configuration and kill the power and save. Okay, confirm connections and reopen the menu. Okay, and off with the power. And as you can see, server immediately lost power. Okay, I just immediately cut off the power. Let's see if the wake on LAN is still working, because this one was working last week, but anyway, I changed the position of the equipment, so maybe I touched something which was not supposed to be touched. So let's see if the wake on LAN is working, so remotely turning on the station. Okay, so let's wait a little bit. Did I? Yes. I remember what I did. I did not use the wake on LAN capabilities. I just put the power back on, but the computer did not start, which is actually what you expect. So that's all for today. I hope this was intuitive, what you can do at home, what you can do at work, how you can interconnect those two. And now, if you have questions, I'm still here and I'm taking questions from you, and I'm going to answer to all the questions the best I can. Thank you.
Thank you, Sorin.
Thank you, Sorin.